Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can take a self-portrait. Now, normally when it comes to photographing people, I'd rather be photographing other people and not myself. But this comes from a question from one of the viewers on the GavTrain website. How do you take a certain type of self-portrait? But I can't do this self-portrait by myself. So let me introduce you to my brother. So there's now two of us. But for this self-portrait to really work, I actually need three of us. So here's my other brother. And then there were three, as if that was bad enough with one of me. Blimey, three of me. Still, there we go. So what I'm going to show you to do is how to take this photograph as a still image and stitch it together using Photoshop. Okay, you guys, away you go. Let's see if we can do this. Now, fortunately, doing this in a still photograph is a lot simpler and a lot more convincing than it was in that terrible video, but it gives you an idea of how we're going to do things. I'm going to take three pictures and then use Photoshop to join them together, and you'll see that at the end of this live action bit. But to make life a lot easier inside of Photoshop, there's a couple of things you can do. The first one is all about cameras, but not the body or the lens you're going to use. That really doesn't matter. It's what you put your camera on. In my case, this great big heavy Manfrotto tripod. Now that's perfect because for each of the three pictures, I want them to be as close to each other as possible. So the camera mustn't move from one picture to the next. Another thing that's going to be the same is the exposure, the settings I'm going to use. So I'm going to set my white balance to flash because we're going to use flashes, and I'll show you those in a tick. But I'm also going to change the exposure settings in camera so it's exactly the same from one picture to the next to the next. Let's have a look at the settings we're going to use. Now I'm going to be working in manual mode and letting the camera's ETTL system work out the basic flash exposure. But I'm also going to put some settings in here. Now let's change the shutter speed to the sync speed, or just below 200th of a second, and we'll choose a nice middle of the road aperture f8 for a good depth of field. Now because I've got to be in these pictures, I need to put it into self timer mode, and that'll give me 10 seconds between pressing the button and the shutter firing. Now you could use any sort of lighting to make this picture work, but I'm going to use off-camera speed lights, and to trigger them I'm using the Pocket Wizard Mini TT1 system to trigger the lights. I'm going to put one light directly behind the sofa, hidden out of sight. That's going to illuminate the background, and we're going to have one light illuminating me. So the second Pocket Wizard Flex TT5 I've got mounted on a small lighting stand with a shoot-through umbrella just in front of it. And I'm going to use that as the main source of illumination. So we'll just fit our second, 580 EX flash gun onto the front. This is going to be our main light, our key light. It's going to be the one that really lights me. And then the second light behind the sofa is going to light the background. And that's it. It's just going to be a simple two-light setup. Okay, so that's the basic setup. Let's actually get on and take the pictures. Okay, well that was kind of weird and fun at the same time. I've ended up with three pictures that I want to bring together and montage into one. So that's the first one. This is the second one. As you can see, the colours and the contrast, the tone, they're the same between one picture and the next. But most importantly, the sofa doesn't move between the three pictures. And that's the key thing. Your static object is static in the picture. It's only me that moves. So what I want to do is to combine those three images into one. So let's do that now. Let's go to select all, edit and copy. We can close this picture down and we'll go back to edit and choose paste, and it's going to paste it in. So I've put one image on top of another, and when I do that I end up with a separate layer. So now my two pictures are on separate layers. All I need to do then is to cut a hole here to reveal the other me sitting on the other side of the sofa. Okay, that's the idea anyway. Now, you could use the eraser tool, and if you're using Elements, that's the best way to go. But I'm using Photoshop, well, CS4 as it happens, so we're going to use layer masks.
So I'm going to put a layer mask on that layer, and I'm going to make sure I have a paintbrush, and I'm going to make sure my paintbrush is black. Now all I need to do is paint black on my layer mask, and it works just like an eraser tool. Why a layer mask and not the eraser tool? Well, it just gives me the option of control, really. If I make a bit of a mistake, and well, that does happen quite often, with a layer mask it's much quicker and easier to put things right. With an eraser tool, it's just a touch more difficult. Okay, so there we go. There's me coming through, get my elbow in, get my shadow in. Brilliant. Okay, and there we are. It's as quick and as simple as that. Having set things up in the camera makes life so much easier when it comes to Photoshop. Okay, well, let's get the other picture, the third one, and we'll go for select and select all, edit and copy, close it down, we don't need it anymore, and paste it in. Now, this one's going to be a little bit more tricky, because this time I've got to overlap me here with the other two me's here and here, so it's not quite as simple and straightforward. I mean, if I was standing at the side, that might have been easier. Why didn't I do that? That would have made life so much simpler. Anyway, I haven't done that, so here's how we're going to tackle it. What we're going to do is to use the magic wand. We'll grab the magic wand tool, and on here where it says sample all layers, make sure you put a tick in there, and I'm just going to click on the white area between my two heads, and that's going to make a selection around there. Now I'm just going to fine-tune this selection, just tidy it up a little bit. So let's go to select, we'll choose modify, and we'll expand the selection. We'll expand it by 2 pixels. Now what that's going to do is to remove any halos, because if I left it as it came off with the initial selection, I'd get a kind of white halo around the edge of my head, and that wouldn't look so good. I'm also going to go back to select, choose modify once more, and feather it. And I'm going to feather it by 1 pixel. Now feathering will just remove any hard edges and just make the blend a little bit more clean and convincing. So now what I need to do is to switch on the top layer like that. You can still we still have the selection active. You can see how it's going to work. Kind of looks quite good. Let's just zoom in a little bit so we can really see how this is going to work. And all I need to do now is just put a layer mask on there. Now, putting a layer mask on when you have a selection means you're not going to get a complete white layer mask. You're going to get a layer mask like that. And hey presto, absolutely perfect. Look at that, works like a treat. It's not until you zoom out that you start to spot any problems like the edges down here a little bit. So we'll just get a paintbrush and we'll just get a little bit of paint in there. We'll just paint a bit of black on the layer mask like that, just to hide those edges and blend it all in nicely. Okay, so there we go. There is how you can take 3 individual pictures, 1, 2, and 3, and create a really quite bizarre self-portrait.